What's going on, guys? Today we've got a few potential Manchester United squad for FIFA 16. Okay, so I'm going to run through the squad basically real quick now with the current players that we've already signed. There's been some great signings so far, by the way. But if you could smash 205 likes on this video, I would really appreciate it. And also, guys, comment down below in the comment section, who do you want me to do next? There's been some big signings this summer. I say it's summer, but it's been pissing it down every day. But yeah, there's been some great signings this summer. Let me know who you want me to do next. I will do absolutely any club. By the way, guys, before we start, yesterday I uploaded an FBL FIFA pack video. You guys told me to swap out some of the players that I didn't want for the other players that I did pack. So someone said to get rid of Pienaar for Depay. Tell me if you think this is fair. Am I allowed to do this or am I not? It's completely up to you guys. I don't mind sticking with the box standard players that I got initially. And I also don't mind replacing them with the better players as well. So, in goal, guys, we're going to kick off with, obviously, De Gea. But is he going to be staying at Manchester United? I don't know. I do think he will stay this year. You know, I do think he'll stay this year. However, there are some other alternatives. And I'm just going to quickly show you who they are. Hugo Lloris, okay? He's been hugely linked to Manchester United if De Gea were to leave. Valdez also wants to leave as well. He's had a bit of a fallout with Van Gaal. There is also another goalkeeper called Sergi Romero, who he's an Argentinian. He's pretty much the first choice Argentinian goalkeeper. So I'm just going to stick Lloris in a squad there, as it's a potential squad. You never know what happens. There's plenty of weeks left for more other transfers to go through. Manchester United centre backs at the moment, I would probably stick Rojo and Smalling in there because they're the strongest two in my opinion. Jones and Evans are also there as well. I think Evans will probably go though. And there's been a few other centre backs linked to Manchester United. Okay, so the two main centre backs that have been linked to Manchester United are obviously Otamendi, we've got here, and also there's a huge player called Sergio Ramos who has also been linked to Manchester United. I don't think Ramos will be the guy that we get, to be honest with you. We've had a few huge signings so far. Apparently, I don't even have him in the club. But anyway, there's been some huge signings so far, guys. We've got Bastian Schweinsteiger. We've also signed Morgan Schneiderlin. I'm not sure how many more we're going to be signing. So I think we're going to probably get a lower world-renowned centre-back, if that makes sense. I do think that Otamendi's possibly going to be the guy for that. But there you go. There's Ramos there who we could potentially be getting as well. Okay, so right back, it's a really easy one, okay, guys? A lot of you know who he is. He's already been signed. He's a guy called Damian. I don't think we're going to be getting any more players in terms of left-backs and right-backs because, you know, we don't need any more now. We've got Rafael, we've got Valencia, we've got Damian now, and we're going to just stick him in there. Look, he's pretty much extinct, by the way. Cannot find him at all. And on the left-hand side, we've got Luke Shaw as well. There we go, Luke Shaw there on the left-hand side. The two centre defensive mids, pretty standard. Bastian Schweinsteiger, and of course, you've also got Schneiderlin. There you go. Of course, you've got Fellaini, who can also play anywhere between CDM, centre mid, centre attacker mid, striker. I ain't stuck him in the squad because I don't think he's part of Van Gaal's first team plans. I know we played absolutely outstanding last year, guys, but I just think with these two new players that he signed, I think he's going for a different approach this year. Centre attacking mid. Now, recently, he's actually been playing Depay through the middle. I know it's all pre-season, but Depay has been playing in the middle. You've had Ashley Young on the left-hand side. I'm just going to move him up there now because he's on the bench. There he is. And we've also had Mata on the right-hand side. Now, a lot of people think Mata's mainly a central player, but he can play on the wing as well. And he has been doing really well there for the last season. But we've also got Di Maria, guys. Now, a lot of people have been saying he's been going to be transferred away. I don't know what's going on with him. Honestly, anything could happen. And you've got Rooney up front as well. Now, I'll run through them, and I'm just going to show you some of the potential players that Manchester United might be buying. Because we've been talking about this mystery striker, okay? And there's a lot of players that could be this mystery striker. The first one we're going to go and show you is Thomas Muller. Now, he's been linked heavily to United, and I would love to have Thomas Muller at Manchester United. He can play up front, he could play as a winger, you know, he's very consistent. At the age he is already, he's already one of Germany's top goal scorers in terms of World Cups. I think he actually took the record away from closer, so he would be a great addition. So we're just going to stick him up front there, and we're probably going to move Rooney into the cam position and then have Depay on the left-hand side. Now, that for me right there, that looks like an absolutely insane squad. But there's a couple of other players that have been linked to Manchester United, and we're going to look at them now. So we've actually been linked to two players from PSG. The first one, Zlatan Ibrahimovic. this is a bit of a push, guys, because Van Gaal and Ibrahimovic apparently have had a bit of an argument in the past, so maybe not so him. But the other one we are looking at is Edinson Cavani. Now, everyone is saying that he would be a great fit for Manchester United's playstyle, and he's been linked heavily to a move away from PSG for a little while now, as he's always saying that he doesn't like to be the shadow behind Ibrahimovic, which is fair enough. Quality striker like Cavani, he wants to be the main man. What would he get along with like when Rooney's there, though? Who knows? And that's pretty much it, guys. You know, there's a couple of other players that we have been linked with, like Pedro, but I didn't want to stick him in there because I don't think we're going to make a move for Pedro. I think he's a fantastic player, but I don't think he's going to be in a United shirt next year. I think he might even stay at Barca, although he does want a way out. I don't know. Maybe even Liverpool's been linked with him. All sorts of players have been linked with him. But anyway, I think this would probably be the team that I would choose if I was in charge. It looks insane for me. Maybe I would choose De Gea over Lloris, so it sticks like that. But there's plenty of options that could be happening, guys. If you want to see another video like this, there's plenty of transfer rumours. It's really fun to see these potential squads and who you could have out there. Really fun doing it. But anyway, guys, yeah, thanks for watching this video. Smash that like button, as I said. Comment down below. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you next time.